Leyden High School District 212 is proud to have been one of the first three school districts in the country to go fully one-to-one with Chromebooks during the 2012-2013 school year. We were able to move from pockets of excellence within the district to equitable and sustainable technology access for all students without charging them any additional fees. By 2015, we were able to close the connectivity gap for our students outside of the school by offering mobile hotspots to any student in need, with every student having a Chromebook and internet connectivity in school, at home, and wherever they choose to engage in their schoolwork. We've been able to systematically integrate tools that extend learning beyond the classroom walls, improve communication and collaboration, enhance content creation, and provide access to valuable educational resources.
So this first year of teaching has been a memorable one, to say the least. I never thought that I would be a remote teacher slash hybrid teacher slash in-person teacher. So technology has helped me tremendously this year just because we're remote, but different applications like Pear Deck or Desmos, where they allow you to have those social emotional learning slides and examples that they can give you, templates that allow me to change them up for my specific classroom and make them more worthwhile and personable to those kids. And having them be able to do work in synchronous time for me to see their work, give them constant feedback, for them to go into breakout rooms, work on slides together so that they're able to talk to one another. Just being able to give that feedback to every individual student, even if they are the quiet kid, even if they are the loud kid, and it's all personalized for them. So I'm never gonna stray away from the technology. I think that after this year, I wanna keep incorporating it and keep finding different ways to use it and have kids do more student-centered work.
Students in the program that I teach, they have more significant disabilities. So in the school setting, they are the students with the most significant disabilities. But that doesn't define them, of course, and we work to bring out their strengths and help them find what they really care about and want to do for the rest of their lives. So if we're using the Chromebook, we're using accessibility features on there, depending if they need text-to-speech, if they need larger print on the screen, if they need a keyboard that has larger print on that, or switches to access the computer. But students in this program sometimes are nonverbal and require some supplements to communicating. So an accessibility tool that they would use might be an AAC device, and that is augmentative alternative communication. And that might even just look like a board of symbols, of like most common symbols of words that are used. But for other students, it might look like an iPad with a whole bunch of symbols on it that they use for voice output as well.
So I think one of the pieces that is very important for us is to try to connect with families in their native language. And that's something that becoming a principal here was very important to me, to provide opportunities and more opportunities for parents to receive the messages in their native language. But one thing that I noticed for our families is there's so many great events and so many celebrations happening at Leyden. And I noticed that a lot of the families didn't feel that they could relate to what was being discussed or described about their kids. And so I had come across the interpretation device that parents can use. And for that, we're able to provide a full-time in-house interpreter who's able to, on the spot, interpret to our families while our families are attending the events. That brings me joy, and parents are excited to get that information in their native language and be able to hear all the great things that are being said about their students.